Jesus, Jesus. I just wanna know. thank him for that, and Brother Bob's worth. Stand up. We thank you for your witness. This ought to be witnessing time. Something we don't understand. Witnessing is the proclamation of the good news. And that's all preaching is. Just doing it maybe more so from a technical standpoint. But witnessing is nothing but proclaiming the love of God. God's goodness in all of our lives. Let me momentarily, without breaking the spirit of this worship moment, let me thank all of the men involved in the men's prayer breakfast yesterday morning. It was a goodness thing. Ladies, I'm sorry you were not able to come, but the Lord bless. And we're praying that this would just be the beginning of a unified effort of our men to forge ahead and to give leadership to our church, spiritually, that is. Because if ever we needed spirituality in the house of God, in these days and times, we need it now. Amen. Just for a moment, open your Bible to the Gospel of John, chapter 13, and the first 6 verses. John 13, verses 1-6. And we want to behold him through his word this morning. Amen. If you have it, stand on your feet. John says it was just before the Passover feast. Jesus knew that the time had come for him to leave this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he now showed them the full extent of his love. The evening meal was being served, and in the King James implies that they had finished the meal. But it really doesn't matter. There's no contradiction there. And the devil had already prompted Judas Iscariot, son of Simon, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning him to God. So he got up from the meal, took off his outer clothing, and wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that was wrapped around him. We won't stop there. Amen. So in the freedom of God's perfect, holy, and transforming word, I want us to look at this drama, because this is the beginning of Christ's suffering.
Go ahead. Here, go ahead, cool off.
Through the upper room experiences and all that's going to take place. And you have to put all 4 evangelists together, from Matthew to John, in order to get the composite and the complete picture. He realizes that what is waiting on him, it is not some lollipops and some ice cream and cake, but it is physical, excruciating pain, agony, disappointment, betrayal, denial, rejection, refusal. All of this is staring him in terms of his soul. And John says that he got up from the meal. And I noted in King James says that he had finished the meal, but it doesn't matter because the evening meal, and the NIV says it was being served. He got up, and I would imagine the disciples, they were wondering, what in the world is Jesus getting ready to do? And he took his robe out of his outer robe off and got a towel and wrapped it around his waist. And then went over to the servant's position, or where a servant slave would normally be, and he would be water there in a basin. And he took the basin and he brought it back over to the disciples and poured the water in the basin. And then he got down on all fours and started washing, grinding, stinking, sore feet. And he washed them one by one, one man at a time. And I would imagine he did it meticulously. He did it slowly. And being God and man, he did it completely. And then he would dry their feet. Now, let's try to put our minds in the mindset of those disciples. Jesus has never done this before. Now, he has shared many a Passover meal with his disciples in the 3.5 years he's been with them. But he's never done this before. This is a strange action. It's peculiar. But John tells us that Jesus knows this is going to be his last meal with them.